Yeah, so because yes, our area of interest does not mean that we can just take a trade here and all be well. No, we still have to pay special attention to the price action. Yeah, so and we can see that the momentum is to the downside. So what we have to do is to go lower to watch the market. So let's move our candle. So now, one of the most common trading mistake is thinking that you can just draw two lines here, and the market will magically respect your line. It does sometimes. You can be right sometimes, but the fact that it's not something that you can be consistent with. It's better to always wait for price action at your area of interest instead of trying to just pick two magic lines. The reason for that is that you want to be accurate. You want to improve your accuracy. You just don't want to take a trade and get stopped that easily. You want to improve your accuracy. That's why you always have to wait. Yeah, or use a bigger stop loss. That's another way to go about it. So in this way, we are waiting for price to probably show us that you want to go up, probably break structure or something. So now this is the market going below our area of interest, but it does not matter to us because we'll never just take a trade just because it's getting to our area of interest. We must always wait for other conferences or confirmation. So now, this right here, these are people call stop points, market just making stop points. So it's things that we try to analyze, not something we try to trade. So we only take a trade when everything has been cleared. So now this is market breaking the trend line. So we can see that, okay, there's intent to go forward. So what do we do next? We wait for our normal break of structure. So you can wait for it to return to the other block. So this area here is a very good area for taking a buy. Still, so that probably you have to wait for a good structure break. So you're still bringing your trend line. So yeah, the momentum, this dance world momentum is probably too much. So now we can see that, okay, in this case, you can probably see that this trend line is like a false breakout when the market did not really close above the trend line. That would call a false breakout. So now we have seen that, okay, this way you start doing your back-off schematic, but the easiest way is to just wait for a true breakout of your trend line, a very true breakout. So in this case, I can see that the candle is closing above my trend line. And I hear that this trend line is cutting across this three consolidation candle. So what do you do? Same stuff. You wait for your breaking structure. That is what we always wait for. So you've always wait for breaking structure. And this way you start going to lower time frame to analyze the market. So now, let's just play. So now, this market breaking this intraday structure, and it's coming back to this area of interest. But the reason why we don't want to enter yet because it's just too soon. It's not, the price action is not clear enough. The market can still come down because this structure is not, it did not take it that way. So we need something to show that there's a good intent of going up. You can see that, okay, market is going up sluggishly. It's not really going up with that intent that it's going to go up. So in this, this is what you just try to analyze and watch, and you wait for that good intent. If you see it was at this area, we not try to take trade in this region. We needed this move showing us that okay, there's a good intention of going up. This actually what is really very important. This intent, like just four candles or bullish, like it's so perfect. So that's what we're waiting for. So now, yeah, this is exactly what we're waiting for. So you can see that just by seeing this push, you cannot see that, okay, the intent for going off is not valuable, unlike this previous area. So after that, we wait for our breaking structure, which is this. Let's go to this time frame. So after that, we can see that our structure has been broken. So now, we now focus on the last candle that caused that break of structure that showed the intent of moving up. That now becomes our area of interest. It's just as simple as that. So it's just a matter of time for the market to return back to there. So things are at this point, the tendency to want to just buy is there. But as you go as a trader, you know that, okay, buying in this type of place is trading error. You just have to wait for price, because if you are buying here and it's coming down, you buy again, because in your mind you'll be like, okay, it has not got you to my area of interest. So it's best to put your limit and then you ignore. Yeah, like you have to learn to ignore some trade. Just take your trade and ignore the trade. It's not all trade. You always have to want to monitor, want to fight. You always have to learn to ignore trade. So yeah, it just stopped that supply zone, and I think, okay, this is on trade. Yeah, it was this area, it was sent to the public channel at this point. So it just stopped that supply zone, and if you are right, the market should not go below the other block. So it's a matter of where should you target. So the first TP was this area. Not this smaller eye, this eye is the first TP. So that's the idea behind taking your trade. So you can see that I'm not really bothered if my stop loss is let me check, this is about, it is about 2 pips stop loss, but I don't really care if my stop loss is 2 pips. Why? Because I'm focusing on execution. So if it happens to be 2 pips, 3 pips, 4 pips, 1 pips, fine. But that's not my main goal. My main goal is to find my trading edge. It's because I'm focused on trying to get my trading edge. That's why I can get a trade of 2 pips. But if I'm focusing on being in a trade of with 2 pips, then I'll probably be taking the wrong area of interest, because I'm trying to force. Yeah, you probably do stuff like focusing on this area of interest because it's probably smaller. So you have to learn to always put on your mindset to focus on what is important. Having a trade with a 2 pips stop loss or 3 pips stop loss is not what is important. What's important is looking for my edge and trading it. If it happens to give me 1 pip stop loss, then that's perfect. But I am not after 1 pip stop loss. Yeah, so before we continue, let me check the chat if there's any. Okay. Let me see any chat post. So yeah, let's continue. So yeah, you can see that the one important thing to know that, like, if you are right, you always get a fast move. You must always get that fast move. Like, it's something to note for. If you take a trade and you get that immediate feedback, then you are doing something right. But if the market is probably taking time to move, then you know that, okay, there's probably something not right there. But it's not like a rule of thumb. The rule of thumb is always knowing your edge. So yeah. So if you are right, the market should not go below where you take your trade. So as soon as we can see that the market is having sign of breaking this first TP, then it's a matter of time to target the reverse eye. So yeah, that was it for the buy. Then I think after you explain the sale, let me check if it's here. Yeah, this was when it was at, I forget, our 1 to 50. So the market got to our sell zone. So like you see, we don't just sell just because the market is in our sell zone. Probably if I'm selling, I have to use a very good stop loss. So you have to look at the price action before you can get a sale. So that was the idea for the sale I took here. So let's analyze the sale. Yeah. So now, yeah, the first thing put into this is to always wait for this breaking trend line. Yeah, that is the first simple thing to do. So it always give you that sign of, okay, I can start looking for sale. So it's something that will make you to be patient. It's something that you can see. It's as simple as seeing it. So you know that as long as the price is above it, okay, I'm not missing that. I'm not worried about anything. I'm not missing that. So it's something that is physical to see. So you can always control your emotion with it. So now, this is the first of. So price getting to, I think I have to go to our time frame. So now, this price getting to our area of interest, but we didn't take the sale, because if I have to take a sale here, I probably have to put my stop loss. Above here, and that's probably like 7 pips. It's not that bad, but at the end of the day, the trade itself is not yet confirmed. So we're after confirming our trade before putting our order, not just trying to take our trade. So now, in this point, let me move this. This is now our area of interest. This up move. So it's too much. We focus on the discount. So this become our area of interest. So we need that we just have to wait for market to get back there to take our trade. So there's actually a trade here to take. As simple as this. But once again, this SL is even more than the original SL I was avoiding to take. So for that reason, you just have to wait for something better. So yeah, let's see what happened. What's wrong? Hello, can you guys hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Yeah, so for that reason, we have to just wait for something better. I think
so. Bro, what time frame did you execute this trade?
I don't really focus on time frame. I focus on the data I'm looking for, not really time frame. As I'm here, I can't look for 2 minutes time frame. I can't see any data in 2 minutes time frame. So I always focus on the time frame that is giving me my data I'm looking for. I don't really care if my stop loss is 2 pip finally. That I don't really care if I end up in a 1 minute time frame. Because I'm focused on trying to read the market. If we didn't take me to 2 minutes time frame, then that's perfect. If it doesn't, then whatever time frame I stop, I analyze with that. So I don't really want to make anybody to start being so glued to time frame. You can probably make as many time frame as you want. Just click through it till you get what you're looking for. So now I know that I can't take this trade yet because the stop loss is too much. So yeah. So what I do is that I wait for market to get there. When it gets there, now I cannot go to something lower. I cannot go to something lower to see that okay, this is the last candle. So let's go back 3 minutes, just let's go back a few seconds. As at this point, being in this time frame, it makes no sense. It is still this time frame that is making sense. So it's not about trying to force a time frame on yourself. No, it's about allowing the market to move the way it wants to move. After seeing this, I know that okay, there'll be a last candle. So what I do is now I cannot go lower to find that candle. So I'm not trying to force myself on a time frame. No. So now this time frame, I can see that okay, my stop loss is probably better than what it was. So I focus on this area of interest for myself. So this area. My network is bad. Can you guys hear me clearly? Yeah. So this is my original area of interest. But because I didn't like the stop loss, I'm just waiting. It's a matter of waiting till you see a perfect stop loss. Let me put it that way. So what happened? The market did what? Book structure. Then I wait for it to return to that area of interest because I can see that this candle here have mitigated all the rubbish here or everything here. So it's probably not needed again. So this is what is needed, this area. So yeah, so if you are new to this time frame stuff, what I have to do is to always focus on higher time frame. I actually encourage people to focus on higher time frame because it's only when you're accurate to your higher time frame, you can start focusing on lower time frame. Then the move here, you focus on the discount of this move. So that'll probably give you this big area of interest. And there's nothing wrong in having this area of interest because at the end of the day, you're after being accurate than taking choose the zombie stop loss. What matters is that you always try to get that accuracy than finding the perfect entry. So yeah. So now you can probably see that the market with that our area of interest. So yeah, so just by following a specific defined process and not focusing on whether I'm using a 2-pip stop loss, this is how you get your entry. So it just tapped in. So now this stop loss now, this is where I probably use second time frame. When when I've seen that, okay, this is my entry, I've been executed, and this is like a 6-piece top loss. At least it's better than this 7-piece top loss. So yeah, so I didn't have the, I went for this, but you can get better. But I don't know if I'm, well, yeah, I think we have 10 minutes left. So I don't know if I'm lazy or what. So things that you can always reduce your stop loss to whatever stop loss you want, as long as you are following the same process, not just forcing it on the market. So in this case, if I want to increase my stop loss, I know that, okay, now, 9 minutes time frame can't show me what I want to see here. So it's common sense to go lower. So I go lower. If it's not clear, probably see go lower. So you probably see what you want to see. So at the end of the day, you're not focusing on the specific time frame. You're focusing on the data you want to see. So we'll keep on going lower. Yeah, and this is what I'm after. This candle here. So it took, I saw it in a 2 minute time frame, but I don't really care about this 2 minute time frame. It's just because I'm looking for a data. And I saw it in a 2 minute time frame. So that'll be what that matters to me. So let me try and delete this. So I'm delete this also. So this 2 minute time frame will now be my year of interest. So this is about a 2.4-piece stop loss. If it's too much, then you just divide into three equal parts. Then you probably take care for your trade short. So now, this is now me taking a trade for 1.5-piece stop loss. So what do I need to see? I need to see my breaking market structure. So now, yeah, after seeing this breaking structure, it's a matter of time of waiting. So now, there's something that is very common. The probability that you want to just focus on this area of interest, but without knowing if this area has been mitigated or not. So now we can probably see that this candle did not mitigate that area of interest. So it's actually still smart to focus on the top. But in return, you can probably not be so calm to know. So now, yeah, so this would be my trade of 1.5 stop loss and probably be perfect. But right now, I ended up in a 1 minute time frame, not because I want to use it. No, it's because my data I'm looking for took me all the way to the 1 minute time frame. So this is what trading is all about, execution. I'm not trying to be perfect. No, it is only when you're focusing on execution, you start having those amazing trades. So that's what I would do to get a 1-piece stop loss, but I guess I was lazy, so I stopped with my 6-piece stop loss. Yeah, the aim is to always know what to do in return. So I know that if I want to get the stop loss better, I follow the same process. And that's what trading is all about. So yeah, so imagine you take this trade with a 1-piece stop loss. You have our vocabulary times 6 of what is this now? This is 1 to 23. With a 1-piece stop loss, it probably be 1 to about 150. But it doesn't matter. There are so many trades. Always focus on the next trade. Don't really dwell too much on your current trade. So yeah. I think this stuff will break even the 1-piece stop loss trade. So yeah, that's it for today. So any question in comment section before we end it? Yeah, also talk about UOGPP and GJ trade. Well, I think we'll probably talk about it on that time. So any question before we call it a day? Yeah, so I guess no question. Yeah, we'll probably have like 4 minutes to wait for question. So let's see.